So I get down here on the ground and do it Sunday night, and I went off and got my crop plug. Went home and got that, and I got back to the store and I said, hang it up.
Somebody didn't want you to do it.
Who taped it for you? I mean, the video, did anybody video it?
Larry. Larry Mitchell, so.
You got a quick release on that.
Yeah, about that way. Am I supposed to do this?
Let's do this one.
Yeah, what is the camera right here, right?
There you go, slide that.
Okay, there you go.
We usually don't use it that much. We usually have more over the phone. I don't know, usually more play ball, baseball.
Thank you. think it's a trap box. Yeah.
Thank you. astronomers, stargazers, magi. Well, no matter what you call us, we're still wise guys. When you think of the Christmas story, you can't help but think of us, especially Melchior, Gaspar, and Balthazar. But there were other wise guys who made that trip that first Christmas, as well as the cooks and camel boys who went with us. How do I know? I was there, and what a trip that was. It all started the night we saw that incredible star.
I've never seen such a star.
Is it a nova or several planets?
Hello? It must be the sign we waited for.
Excuse me?
This star must announce his birth.
Sirs? Excuse me, miss, for those the wise guys.
Boy, you must have rolled in on the back of a pomegranate cart. Of course they are. Y'all, wise guys.
Don't mind Cookie, my boy. How may we help you?
My name is Jesse, and I travel all over the quest to become a wise guy.
I see. Well, I'm Melchior. This is Gaspar, and Balthazar.
That's right, son. You see, we're trying to hurry up as quickly as possible to go find the Heavenly King.
Why else would God announce his birth with such a magnificent star if he weren't a king sent from heaven? But you wouldn't know about such things, and we really must be going.
But I do know about the king, and you're right. Isaiah said one like the Son of Man would come with the clouds of heaven, and Balaam said a star shall come forth from Jacob.
What a goofy idea. Like, I'm sure with all the ways God can tell us about a king, he's going to use some overwhelmed star.
But what better way for God to speak to stargazers than through a star? After all, that is our life.
And besides, I've always been taught God doesn't think the way we think, or do the things the way we do. If I may say so.
There were many wise men, and clever women too.
Prince of Peace. look for getting packed up and ready to go. Okay, let's go west, wise guys. Go west.
I'm not sure, Jesse, but I know it'll be worth it when we get there.
Just imagine what it'll be like to finally see the king.
To enter his stately palace, to look upon his majestic throne,
to see his magnificent crown.
I can hardly wait.
Can I see the king? I will worship him.
When I see the King, I will worship Him by singing anthems sweet.
When I see the King, I will offer Him the treasures I possess.
To worship Him, worship Him.
Give Him honor, give Him glory, give Him hearts filled with praise. I will bow before His throne, all my days.
Bye.
the little town of Bethlehem.
See how still it lies?
Hold your camel's eyes, guys. How do you know that's where the king is?
She's got a point. It is an awfully small place for a king.
She's right about that.
It's terribly tiny.
Wait a minute. I remember now. Even though Bethlehem is small, Micah said out of it will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of his people.
Me? We're almost there?
Yes, Cookie, after all this time, we're almost there.
Yeah! Yeah!
But a place from which he reigns.
And we can give him those.
Yes, our praise will be his crown, and
our hearts will be as strong.
Thank you.
after that first Christmas, nothing was the same. Tough cookies became tender-hearted faith walkers. Wise men realized that God's wisdom was far above their own. And simple camel boys became wise guys when they gave their lives to the Heavenly King. At least this camel boy did. Would you like to become a wise guy? You can. Just take a trip with your heart to the manger and worship the King.
Tonight, if in some way you've been touched with this message,
desire to give your life to Jesus Christ, and Linda's going to be coming and leading us in this song that's entitled, My Gift Is Me.
Because there's enough light in the room that you can see the back of your programs. The words and the music is printed there. The children have already sung it. So I think that you will be familiar with the tune and even the words. I'll sing it for you one time, and then let's sing it together as a hymn of commitment and invitation this evening.
Not only is the present in good hands, but the future is as well. I'd like to ask all of you who have been prompters and leaders up here if you'll kind of stand and turn around and let everybody see who it is that's beginning all these singers up here. Begin with Sandra, who's kind of directed it and putting it all together. I have three or four announcements that I've been given to give to you. First of all, if you desire to partake in communion tonight and not have the opportunity.